We have so many jolly things to talk about today, but first of all, it's awful in a way that we have to talk about such sadness abroad. Now, do you have any reservations at all about going to Kosovo to get involved in this campaign?
Oh, yes. I didn't know what I was going to see or what was going to be expected of me, really. And I didn't know, selfishly, you know, how I would respond to it, whether I'd be able to deal with it, what I'd get sort of emotional and all of that. But there's so much great stuff going on that kind of compensates. But nevertheless, a lot of it was very harrowing.
So you kept a diary, I gather, while you were away.
Yeah.
So what is it that you really remember most about it, you know, the impact that it's made on you emotionally?
Well, definitely it was talking to the children and all of their stories. And there was one boy who definitely stuck out because he was very articulate in the telling of his particular story. And it was... Everybody was really, really moved by it. The story was replicated a million times with other children as well, but it's just that he told it so well. And he was forced to flee his home and with his family. He was 11 at the time that this happened, and on a tractor with all the belongings in the back. And they fled from village to village. And then eventually they were on a road heading for Albania in a convoy with lots of other people, and they were stopped. And this boy, who was, you know, a child, and lots of other children, saw 74 members of his family and community and friends murdered, men and young men, murdered in front of him. And then his father was taken away at gunpoint. He's never seen him since. He must be dead. And he was told to get up and drive the tractor or else, you know, and he said, I'm too young to drive the tractor. You know, and... his childhood was gone that day, that, you know, robbed of his childhood.
The enormity of war on this scale, because, you know, we sit in our own homes watching it, as we did do, night after night on television.
Yeah.
And there's a little part of you that says, what can we ever do in order to help? Now, when you actually went there with some preconceived ideas, were you stunned, shocked? You know, did it have an everlasting effect on you? What way did you come away from the country?
I felt very lucky. Felt very lucky to live in a stable place like this. I mean, no, we moan about, even with everything that's going on yesterday, you know, it is nothing like what those children face there. I mean, yeah, I was incredibly moved as well, obviously, as you would be. And, it really spurred me, and I felt, yes, wars are waged against children.
They're the ones who really suffer.
They are the ones who suffer, and they aren't the ones who've waged these wars.